I'm Doug Andrus. I'm a professor in the Department of Biochemistry and the Assistant Dean for Research in the College of Medicine. I'm interested in how cells communicate. In particular, the proteins that I study are called small G proteins, and they help to connect information that's coming into a cell with tasks that the cells might do. What we do is try to understand those switching molecules, particularly because they often are damaged or broken, and that can cause human disease. So I became interested in brain injury really because of location. So the University of Kentucky has one of the premier spinal cord and brain injury research centers in the country. And attending seminars and getting to know some of the researchers in that center. And so we had been studying G-protein switches, and I thought to myself that these switches are likely to play important roles in brain injury. Kentucky is really unique because the state has set aside funds in the Kentucky Spinal Cord and Brain Injury Research Trust, and that provided seed money for me and my collaborators to carry out studies in which we're able to show that if we remove the RIT protein, that the severity of their brain injuries was increased, and then we expressed an activated version of our switch, and we showed that that generated a significant amount of protection. And so really, it was the combination of being located next to world-renowned experts in brain injury research, the ability to get funds from the state of Kentucky that supported our pilot studies, that allowed us to really get to the point where we are today, getting a large grant from the National Institutes of Health. This is really a collaboration between three researchers: myself studying cell signaling, Kathy Satman, who's in the SCoBIRC Center, who's an expert at animal models and using animals to model brain injury, and then Chris Norris, who's an electrophysiologist, and he's able to analyze neurons and neural networks. And the studies that we've been able to do with the Satman lab and the Norris lab suggest that when we alter RIT function, we're not just affecting, for example, the survival of neurons following injury, but also we're affecting their ability to retain contacts with their neighbors. Think about, you know, the wall switch in your kitchen, but if you went into the basement, you'd have that box on the wall where you could flip a master switch, and that might turn off all of the circuits into your kitchen. And we think that the RIT protein may be sitting at a master level, and its ability to regulate this suite of pathways is what makes it so powerful in its ability to counteract the effects of brain injury. And we're hoping that the money we've gotten from the NIH will permit us to carry forward those studies, and ultimately, the hope would be that we would uncover cellular pathways that could be manipulated through drugs to help people who suffer a brain injury. The power of being at UK was that I could easily, within the campus, talk to experts in various aspects of what is a very complicated disorder, and they were kind enough to both give me information, talk to me, to educate me in this area, which was new, and then their willingness to collaborate on this project was really, you know, quite amazing.